Hello friends, in this video let's talk about how to implement sorting in SSRS report. This is one of the important feature in SSRS report. This really improves the user experience in SSRS report. You can sort the report or you can sort the data based on any columns. I mean, you can sort the data based on the string column, you can sort the data based on the boolean column, you can sort the data based on the integer data type columns. Even you can keep sorting on all the columns in a tabular report. Mostly we will be using sorting in a tabular SSRS reports. So let me show you. So what is the data I am going to use for my example? See, I am planning to use AdventureWorks 2019 copy of a human resource employee table, so which of having around 10 plus columns and 290 records here. So I am planning to use this table data for my report example. So let's quickly go to the Visual Studio. So let's quickly add a new report, add a new item, and let's select this report and let's select the name as, let's type the name as sort. So I'm giving a meaningful name to understand in a better way when I see the number of reports. So let's quickly add a data source. I already have a one shared data source in my example. Let's make use of that. Let's quickly come to the data set. Let's use this and let's keep the text as this. Okay, let's copy this. Let's paste this, click on OK. Yeah, now the data set also ready. Let's go for report design now. So let's take a tabular report. Okay, so let's keep this side here. So let's put this as a national entry number and a login ID and see the data is coming or not. Yeah, data is coming. So let's add a couple of more columns to see in a data either right side or left side. So here as a job title, there's a birth date, so write as a martial state or like, yeah, martial status, and add one more column at right as a gender, and let's say take as a hire date, and let's see the data is coming or not perfectly. Yes, of course. Let's quickly come here. Let's add a business entity ID here. Okay, see, this is a basic design. Okay, this is a basic design. I'm not going to put a lot of styles here. Let's quickly come here and let's add some styles to the header so that understanding will be more easier. Let's add a color of light color. Click OK. Let's quickly go to the preview. And then, yeah, so the output looks like this. Now I have a border to the header, and header is little bold actually if you see. And I can easily see, and the data report is scattered across a couple of pages. See, yeah, around 7 pages report is scattered across 7 pages. So which contains 290 records. So let's see, this is how, let's increase the length through the login ID. So to make sure that at least display will be, let us see, it got stuck. So this might be a Visual Studio not responding now. So let's quickly see. Yeah, it's Visual Studio is back now. So let's quickly increase the length to the login ID little so that the report look and feel will be little nice. Okay, so let me increase something to the job title as well, just to increase the readability of the report. See, you need to improve the readability of the report, and you need to improve the experience, like a user experience on the report actually. So because this is a front end reports actually. Okay, so still I can improve some more to the even birth date or something like that. Let me do for birth date as well. Okay, even I can remove this so that I don't need this much of size for this. Okay, so let us see. Yep, somewhat better. Let me take the hire date also some more. It's somewhat better actually. So if the job title is too big, then we cannot do anything. That's okay. Now, so now let's come to the point, like how to implement a sorting actually. See, here I'm not, I don't have a data in a specific order. So whatever the query is giving, the data is coming and sitting into the tables here, okay? In the report actually, if you come here. So I want to see all the males in first, then I want to see females based on my need actually later. Or I want to see singles first or later married people. Or I want to identify the list of people who born in the early years or later years. Or I want to see who are all eyed in the recent dates or something like that. So I need to provide that kind of facility to the users to get the details on a need basis, on a demand basis. So if I supply data through a SQL query, I can get only one scenario. If I get a comfort to the user, he can sort the data based on his need actually. Okay, so let's quickly go to the design and implement a sorting actually. Now you need to design on what column basis you want to sort. So first of all, I want to sort based on the hire date. So I want to identify the people who joined recently to the company or who joined early in the company. Okay, so like let's select that particular text box or let's particular cell. Okay. See, this is a cell, okay? So hire date is a cell which has been selected now. So right click on hire date and go to text box properties. So I want to apply sorting on a hire date header actually. That's the reason why I selected that hire date column. Okay, so once I click on text box properties, I'll get this. Let me show you again. So select this cell, hire date cell, right click and click on text box properties. So there here you can see couple of options to the left side, general number alignment and all. Somewhat at the bottom you have interactive sorting. Select that feature and click on enable interactive sorting on this text box. So I just selected and it asks on what column or what databases you want to sort. Okay, here you have an option to select that particular column. So I want to sort the data based on hire date only. So whenever I apply a sort button there, I get a sort button now. Since I am enabling this, I get a sort button. If I click on that, the data will be sorted on a hire date column, either ascending or descending based on the data condition. Let's click on OK. Now, so I enabled a sorting on the top of hire date header for hire date column only. So now let's save this, come to the preview. So once you come to the preview, you can see a little difference here. So if you see business entity ID, only header is there. National ID number, only header. Login ID and all the other columns has only headers. And for hire date, you have like a two small up arrow and down arrow buttons. So let's click on one time. So you will get a data in a specific order. Okay, maybe ascending or descending. So now you can see the person who joined in 2006, next 2007, 2007, 2007 and so on, 2008 and so on. So let me click on again here. So now you are getting 2013. I think the recent employee joining date in that particular company is 2013 only. So there are no other people joined later to the 2013. So now you can easily see it, okay, on a hire date. So I want to see who are all like, I want to sort based on the gender. So, but I do not have an option on the gender here. So now that's how now user might ask, can I sort the data based on gender or can I sort the gender based on status, marital status or birth date or job title. Currently, I did not provide that comfort to the end user. Now he need to export the data into somewhere, then only he can see it. Okay. So let's quickly go to the design and let's provide the comfort actually. Okay. So this sorting is happening on the front end screen actually. Okay. Now let's come to the gender here. Select the gender cell now. Okay. So right click on it. Click on text box properties. So go to interactive sorting. So now enable interactive sorting on this text box. Once you enable it, so other boxes, other options will be enabled here. So now come to the sort by here. Now you need to select. So when I click on this one, marital status, right? This is gender it seems. Yeah, this is gender. This is gender. Okay, let's come here. Now select the gender. So there are a couple of cases. Okay, now let me go there. Let's go to the preview. Then I'll tell you that scenario as well. So here I got the options for gender and hire date now. Let's quickly come here. So all females came first. If I re-click again, I'll get all the males. Okay. So now according to this data, other columns will be adjusted actually. Okay. So even if I click now, all 2016, all male and female, my now again mixed here. Okay, because here you can see now what column basis data is sorted is high date. So other columns are with two hyphens now. Let me click this. This is having one and this is having two. Okay, now, so there are common issues like people face is, so like while setting up the gender, okay, a sort box for gender, so they'll select wrongly some different column. Let me select them, martial status. Now, so when you go to preview here, so when I click on this, so here gender M&F mixed actually. Okay, even though I apply a click on gender, but the data is sorted based on the martial status. Here if you see, all M's comes first. Next, later will go for yes. Okay, so that's common mistake developers used to do it. They wrongly map the columns and they used to cross verify why it is happening. Even though I kept sorting for gender, why it is why it's not working? Is it something SSRS issue or Visual Studio issue? People used to think it's a very common issue. Okay, let's go back and fix that issue. Select the gender, go to text box properties, interactive sorting, change the martial status to gender. What data you are displaying, you need to map the correct column. Then you will get the sorting correctly now. Okay, male and female like this. Now, you want to see the birth date sorting. Okay, let's come to the birth date here. Select the header. Right click, text box properties. Go to interactive sorting. Select this option. Sort by birth date. Yeah, birth date. Click OK. Go to preview. Now, sort apply it. So, here it is randomly displaying now. 1969, 71, 74, 74, 52 here. If you see, the order is not there. Let me click on it. Now you'll get 51, 52, 52, 53, 55 and so on. Let me re-click again here. Now the younger one is this guy, okay? And so this guy with a national ID number of this and she born on 1991 of May 31. So this is how I apply sort on the birth date. So I showed you how to apply sort on date column or varchar columns. And date. Let me apply something on a integer column, business entity ID. Let me click come here. So by default, the data will come and sit into the sequential order 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. Okay, this is some IDs are not coming here, but this is a Visual Studio issue only. But when I export it, it will come automatically. Let's quickly come here. Let's enable sorting for this business entity column, that is integer column. Let's go to text box properties, go to interactive sorting, select this option. Select this entity ID, click OK. Now let's go to the preview. Now you have an option for business entity ID, birth date, gender and hire date. Let's now sort it. So now I got 1, 2, 3, 4 by default. Now click on it, 290, 290, 289, 288 and so on like this. Okay, so the data is sorted based on ascending and descending. See, even you can do only either ascending or descending. Only two options you have in interactive sorting. Okay, so this is how we implement sorting in SSRS tabular reports. So this is one of the important feature and it improves the readability or user experience in the SSRS report managers. So that's it. Let's meet in the next video. Thank you.